unfortunately, it's still inconclusive.
This camp was thought to be cursed.
What's that in the corner right there?
That looks like a reflection?
Tonight on Unusual Entertainment TV, we bring a lot of glamorous stories of crime, sleaze, and murder. You will see the documentary Last Tapes from Winston Camp, where we see the last footage of a group of teens who went missing and are still missing today. Along with that, we will witness the trial of Chastity Martin, found guilty of murdering Reggie Burroughs in cold blood. We will start with an update on that.
So we're here tonight at Stevenson, Mississippi's courthouse, where we have Chastity Martin, who was found to be guilty for murdering Reggie Burroughs, a good-hearted Christian man who was the stepfather of Chastity before disowning her after she came out as a lesbian. Chastity is here on trial while the authorities examine the body of Reggie Burroughs for an exact cause of death. Chastity hasn't given much detail, although we can find that her surname was originally Futrell. She took on the last name of Martin when converting the cult of the Martin family. We will be back after each break to provide further updates on the trial. Until then, let's start our program.
Winston Camp, a Boy Scouts camp with a dark criminal past. The counselor was said to have gone insane. Some believed he was a member of the fabled Martin family cult. Some say he murdered the Boy Scouts. No one knew whatever happened to him. Some believe he died, some believe he vanished. Whatever happened left a huge impact on the area. People refused to go near it, and anyone who came close to that piece of land felt such a disturbed, negative presence that drove them away. Animals mysteriously died there, voices were heard, anyone around the area felt as if they were not alone. In 1992, enthusiastic history buff Andrew Bennings decided to take a trip to the campsite with his cousin Kayla Davis and their friend Drew Lawrence. No one knew where they were or what happened to them before. They were said to have vanished. Missing posters were posted. Manhunts were sent all over Stevenson and Old Millardsville, Mississippi. It wasn't until 1993, a year later, that some remains were found. Along with the remains was Andrew's camera, which carried the final footage of three. In this documentary, we will discuss the bloody history of the camp, provide some theories, and show you the footage of the three unfortunate victims in their final moments.
Thank you.
My name is Joshua. I'm the head of the Stevenson University, and we're here to investigate three missing students.
It was a snowy day during an investigation. We were ready to call quits until one of my colleagues found a trail of what happened to be the remains of an old Boy Scout camp.
It was strange, because we found that this was indeed the old Winston camp. I heard of the place before, but just assumed it was a fable or ghost story. I tried to rationalize things the best I can, but as we investigated this place, I felt hugely uncomfortable. Watched and claustrophobic. I have heard a lot of stories about Walker Winston in this camp, and to this day, people still have no idea what really happened to Walker Winston. I wrote it off as maybe just paranoia, but I did feel something otherworldly and uncanny while I was here. I was the first to find the body of Andrew. He was all decayed and smelly. I also noticed that he had a camcorder and tapes, so I automatically took those and cared for them as best as possible for evidence. We also didn't know who it was at first. We assumed it was Andrew Bennings based on the videos, but we still had to be sure.
I was the first to find out the news about Andrew, and I notified my sister, his mother, about it. They too were all upset. I knew from the beginning that he was going to get himself into trouble, however. He and Drew used to hang out with me, and my daughter Kaylee used to cause trouble. They all seemed to be acting weird before they left, but we just brushed it off until they were gone for a month.
Stevenson, Mississippi. We just celebrated the new year. It's now 1991. That was last year. 1992 is the year now. Oh, silly me. But anyway, welcome to Stevenson. I'll show you around because we're about to go on a trip for this new year. We're going to a supposedly haunted camp owned by a very supposedly deranged man named Walker Winston. We'll tell more of the story. I just want to show more because I'm going to invite two of my friends over. We're going to go and stay there and see if we can find ghosts or demons or anything spooky.
Welcome to Stevenson. I mean, just look at this place. It is a beautiful day, beautiful January weather and everything like that. Just waiting on my friends. The soda machine. Let me just look at that. Coca-Cola. And that is a tree. Enter only. Oh, exit only. Oh, I had to enter to exit, really. And there's the town. Oh, yes. The nicest weather Stevenson has ever had. Usually it's hot as balls. Right now, it's actually really nice. I can actually go outside and it's fun and everything like this. I'm glad I hired some more reliable friends, because even in this weather, I just have some friends who are just so lazy that they just don't want to do anything. Yeah.
You saw the movie back in 84. You saw it again on VHS and Laserdisc. And now you can get the best experience on DVD. Watch as a group of criminals kidnap this man and make him into their own cyborg. It backfires, however, and turns him into an awesome cyberkinetic hero. Now, on DVD, complete with a behind-the-scenes look, director's commentary, and everything else from the original Laserdisc, including more. More behind-the-scenes, more concept art, more everything. Cyberpunk Rock, now on DVD. Here's how to order.
For fresh delivery of a Cyberpunk Rock DVD, use a credit card and call 1-800-021-5995 or send $29.99 plus $4.95 shipping handling to P.O. Box 924, Reaganville, Texas 13232.
did it take to make you scream? I mean, really scream.
What if I put you in my next film?
It's your chance to win a part in the sequel to the hit movie Scream by entering MTV's Scream Again contest.
You were born to play this role.
Practice lines with Neve Campbell, get into character with Liev Schreiber, and find your motivation with Courtney Cox. Once the role is yours, we'll fly you to the coast, put you up in a posh hotel, get you to the set in time for your close-up, and pay you $5,000. Of course you get to bring a friend. Who's gonna believe you were really in the sequel to Scream if you don't have a witness? To enter, just send a postcard to MTV Scream Again Contest, P.O. Box 1211, Radio City Station, New York, New York, 10101. Or call 1-900-420-2222. 75 cents per call. Touchtone phones only. So have your people call our people. Actually, we'll call you, because MTV loves you, babe. This MTV contest is brought to you by Slim Jim.
The number one comedy in America is Austin Powers.
Smashing baby!
Siskel and Ebert give it two thumbs up.
Oh, behave.
A very, very funny movie.
That is one crazy get-up you got there, fella.
That only gets funnier.
A lot's changed since 1967.
I laughed till I cried.
Name, Austin Powers.
Sex? Yes, please.
Mike Myers is hilarious.
Groovy, baby.
Austin Powers. Rated PG-13. Now playing.
Now coming to DVD, Mutant Walrus. The action-packed story of how our fishermen on the beach mutated with the walrus, becoming a mutant walrus. When the town is run by criminals, punks, and mutants, Mutant Walrus doesn't play around. And on this DVD, you can see a behind-the-scenes look, including behind-the-scenes on the stop-motion effects. Walrus, PG-13, and R-rated director's cut.
On our update, we could not get Chastity to say much more. However, she has been scribbling demonic messages in a little notebook, as we will now see. As disturbing as these are, what really stands out is a message that reads, "The dark storm is coming. The first stage of the apocalypse is near. There will be floods, tornadoes, and fires. He who shall devour the world is rising."
Based on what we found, there will be a storm eventually be coming to Millardsville, Mississippi. We don't know how long, though. Back to you.
We'll be back with more information. As for now, let's return to the program.
Hey, you kids. I'm a donkey who has a head that is open to everywhere all over time and space.
Andrew was one of my best students. He always took great videos of my biology class.
Andrew used to work part-time for me and Sarah, and we knew he was obsessed with cameras and would record a lot of events. So we gave him the duty of videography, as well as using our video editing facilities.
Check this out. We are in the woods. This here is Drew. This here is Kayla. So, you guys want to hear why we're here. Like, you want to hear the story, right?
Yes.
So here's the story. It's said that there used to be a campsite here. Back in the 50s, there was this guy, his name was Walker Winston. He was said to be a really mentally disturbed man. It's
Like, some people believe, like, he was a huge Satanist or cultist or whatever. And there are some kids who went here who vanished mysteriously, and even Walker Winston himself disappeared. They thought either he took them to hell with him, or he just disappeared. Some say his ghost is still haunting these woods. Some say that maybe he's still haunting these woods as some deranged hermit or anything like that. But don't let that keep you guys from leaving the woods or anything like that. It's just like an urban legend. There's no telling if it's true or not. But it is true that there used to be a camp here, and I'm hoping we can find some elements of it. What the hell is that?
What?
Like a piece of garbage or something like that.
Ugh.
Yeah, let me see. So, May 15th, 1951. Hey, this must be from one of the old Boy Scouts.
So they hid it in a log?
Who knows? It is the second day. Walker taught us... Wow, this guy's grammar is crap. Anyway, Walker taught us how to use a... Us... that's it. There's a E in use. To use a bow and arrow instead. Sadly, one of the boys was shot. He got taken to the hospital, and we went fishing in the creek. We then pled... There's a... We then played stickball and learned knots. We slept, and I heard a ghost. There's an H in ghost. I think it was a ghost. It was saying Walker's name, and Walker looked scared. Scarred. Wow. Talk about grammatical issues. I mean, I know this is a little kid, but I mean, still. I'm... Let's keep looking. I don't know. There's no telling. Be a little careful. We don't want to step in anything like briar patches or anything like that. Walker, Texas Ranger. Wow. Wait, I can't get a good visual on it. I see it, but not my camera work.
Is that a truck or a car?
Yeah, let's check that out. Zoom in. Wonder if there's any dead bodies in there. That would be awesome. Dead bodies.
One can only hope.
Nope. I wonder who used to own this truck and how it got out here. Hey, up here. Oh, there must be some good stuff in this thing. Oops. Thank you. Huh, must be the rest of that journal. I don't know how that other page got out there, but let me see what there is. May 14th, 1951. It is the first day of camp. We decided to check out the woods to hunt deer. Our leader, Walker Winston, first taught, again with the grammatical issues, taught us to use a gun, but he was almost arrested. He brought us back to the bunkers, and we ate lunch. There's an E in ate, stupid. He then told us a ghost story of a man who sold his soul to the devil. It is said that he searches for people to get his soul back. You're sure not talking about Walker Winston? That's what the urban legend said. May 16, 1951. We woke up and found that Mikey and Paul got taken to the hospital because their hut burned. We are now in the woods, and I made a fort in this old car that I found. It's really cool. There's an apostrophe in it right there. So I decided to sleep in it. I'm awake now, and it's dark. It's so cool, and I can hear coyotes that look more like cooties. I see Walker coming to bring me inside, so I better get ready. Huh, that's where it ends. Let's take this bag with us. It might have something useful.
Yeah,
I'll take the bag. Something unique over there. Look on the bright side, guys. At least the weather's nice and cool out here. This is.
Look.
What?
What is that?
Jeez.
Oh my gosh, that's.
Is that real or what? Yeah, you're right. Maybe touching that's not a good idea.
It's too small for an adult. Kids' school. Great.
Yeah, Boy Scouts. It was said that certain Boy Scouts got murdered here. Let's just leave this here. We might get the cops to look at this, but I'm still determined to find the rest of that camp.
Mind me why we're here again?
Well, because we want to do something a little fun. I mean, we don't really get to go out that much, and it's nice, cool weather.
Yeah, enjoy yourself.
Oh. So check this out. That's another thing to add to this little video. We found what may have been a human skull. We left it there because there's no telling what kind of germs are in it. I made the dumbass decision to touch it, so I'm going to have to really wash my hands. I'm pretty sure I have some hand sanitizer in my bag. I just don't want to get it right now because I'm kind of busy doing this. Yeah. Why would it be incriminating? Oh, yeah, that's true. Other weird things around here. That is nothing, but I don't know what it is.
Worst comes to worst, we could always get back in that truck.
Yeah. Well, actually, maybe not. That's one of the old huts, so at least we'll have shelter. Sun's getting bright. Something up there, so I'm pretty sure if we go up there, we'll find some shelter or something. Just get a good zoom. Looks abandoned, but it looks like a place we could stay at.
Definitely not suspicious.
We checked around the old truck and found no evidence of dead bodies. We also couldn't find the skull as if it was moved. Of course, most of this camp was thought being of nothing, more than just an urban legend. We could never truly find what was real or just fiction.
The controversial slasher film that shocked millions is coming soon to Unusual Entertainment Television, fully uncut. Relive the horror. Relive the terror. Tape it so you'll never forget it.
Following will be some exclusive behind-the-scenes footage, including a behind-the-scenes look on how the most controversial scene was done. Lumberjack premieres on October 3rd at 12 a.m. Central Standard Time.
Force One clear for takeoff.
Mr. President, welcome aboard, sir.
Go, go!
How the hell did they get Air Force One?
On July 25th, being President of the United States, the time to negotiate is over.
This president is a Medal of Honor winner.
He knows how to fight.
I would like to ask all Americans to pray for the safety of everyone on board Air Force One.
Harrison Ford,
get off my plane!
Are you one of those people who think you can't buy a good quality new or pre-owned automobile because you've had credit problems?
Wake up!
If you have a job, you have credit. Call the automated credit approval hotline right now at 800-523-9001. Call from home. Get results fast in less than 1 hour. You won't have to talk to a salesperson or fill out paperwork. Call right now. The automated approval hotline brought to you by Chrysler Plymouth of Paramus.
You saw the movie back in 84. You saw it again on VHS and Laserdisc. And now you can get the best experience on DVD. Watch as a group of criminals kidnap this man and make him into their...
We interrupt this program because of a local emergency. Important information will follow. We interrupt this program to activate the emergency broadcast system at the request of the National Weather Service.
We interrupt this program to bring you an emergency alert. A severe thunderstorm has entered Stevenson and Millardsville, Mississippi, and a tornado has touched down on Highway 55 in Millardsville. A second tornado is expected to touch down Glen Parton, Stevenson. Anyone in those areas must get to a safe space immediately, whether it be a basement or closet. Cover up with blankets, cushions, pillows, and avoid all windows. We also advise anyone in Millardsville to avoid downtown as much as possible, as there is some flash flooding in that area. Keep a TV or radio on hand to listen for any further updates.
He watched as they marched. He killed while they made music. And now it's on DVD. Bandcamp Massacre. This DVD will give you a behind-the-scenes tour on how the movie was made. So march with us to buy Bandcamp Massacre. Bandcamp Massacre. Available in stores for only $19.95.
So here we are. We're about to camp because we found, like, a nice little area. I mean, it's weird and abandoned, but... let's take a look at what it's like. Looks nice. It's kind of kept up. Wonder if that's all any good still. That's odd. I don't know what they could be hiding in there.
Maybe a dead body.
Who knows?
If we're looking.
Pretty sketchy. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the power should have been shut off years ago. I guess this must be where, like, they kept the kids, like, this must be like bunkers. And a nice big room. I mean, this is probably where it had the TV. Nice window. There's a refrigerator.
Oh! That's nasty. Don't go in there.
I can smell it from here. It's, yeah, they're quick. dead body is what it is. Blame is on me. I shouldn't have opened that.
I'm used to being around stick.
And then we have this area. This is big enough. Don't open that fridge. Let's just not bother. We already have one room that needs to be aired out.
That'd be so cool, man.
Gonna get my things ready. We are on the first night, just sitting around. We're probably just gonna sleep in here. Like I said, that room is still airing out from the stank of that refrigerator. That's why I decided not to open that one. Luckily, we have our own cooler that's outside. So we haven't really experienced too much of anything. I heard a few noises, and we saw that door that was locked, but nothing unusual. Hold on a second. Did you guys hear anything? Sounded like a... It almost sounded like a grunt or something.
Like an animal or a person?
For safety's sake, I'm just going to say it was an animal. I mean...
Probably. I mean, it's abandoned. It could be an animal hiding out here or something.
Yeah.
A fox or...
I mean, there could be, like, cow room or something like that, for all I know. Well, we're gonna try to find a way to sleep in here, so, like, I guess we'll see you guys on the next day. It's the night of the first day. Pretty strange day so far. Kayla and Drew are sleeping right now, so I just wanna investigate around right there. Found something interesting. I want to take a closer look. We're in this journal entries. At one point, it mentioned a hut that burned down mysteriously. That's even in part of, like, a little bit of history that's known about the place. I think I might have found the little hut. I don't know why it's so far from the other hut. I guess maybe they had separation. Like, maybe they originally had two different counselors. There's the moon. I just want to get that. Anyway, look over there. Oops. It's all in its glory. I mean, look at that thing. Damn. Whoa. Probably just animals. Gotta think rationally about these things. And look at that. I know a way around this game. I'm gonna get around there to get a better visual. Okay. I need to keep my eye on the ground. I don't want to step into any animal but... Looks like the burnt hut.
side of there, but... Ugh, good God, it smells like something's gone over here.
I can't breathe through my mouth a little bit. It's like a bunch of rats died over here. Makes sense, I mean. Man, this place is... That's scary. I sound like a dork, but I don't want to breathe through my mouth. It smells like dead rats over here. I don't know if they're animals or not, they probably are. I need to get away from it, that smells much. We had a cat once who used to bring in animals one time. He got a dead mouse, crawled under like a cabinet or something and died and stunk up the place. This is, I can still smell it. Hold on. This bush. Damn. Okay, I think the smell is gone, or at least it's not that overwhelming. What is that? I'm gonna turn this off for a little bit. I want to check something. It's no wonder there's some weird that happened here. I gotta tell this to my other friends, but just for the sake of this video, I just wanted to point out that there's this cult led by this group called the Martin family. There's been mythos about it and stuff like that, nobody's too sure. But it's believed that they would sacrifice their victims by stabbing them with a specific voodoo knife, spreading their blood in an altar so that way their souls would be fed to hell. I don't see any blood stains, but, you know, brain and stuff might have washed away, or... I don't know. I wonder if any of the people who ran this camp were cultists, or if it just gave them bad luck or something. Huh. Now I want to explore more. Gotta bring the others to see this later. Pretty freaky shit.
While when doing research, we found that this place was once used by a group of cultists under the fabled Martin family, which were said to have spread the innocent blood on altars to damn their souls.
The Martin family was an alleged group of cultists who were said to have been roaming the earth for centuries. Most of their early evidence is not too clear, as it blurs between reality and mythology. Some early sketches and documents state that the tribe started as a group of survivors from the flood of Noah's Ark who took refuge on an island to start their rituals.
One of the earliest stories of the tribe was a partially lost story called The Trials of the Hero. This story was thought to be true, but it is uncertain as to what is mythological and what is true. It tells of a hunter named Connor, although there is no record of this person actually existing. There was a silent film made about it in 1911, which was destroyed by members of the cult. One surviving copy was found in a barn once owned by a filmmaker and historian Henry Matthew. This camp was thought to be cursed, and it is believed that Walker Winston converted to this cult.
And we knew that he was obsessed with finding out about this cult. He'd always share his information with me and Drew as well.
Andrew was a nut on this and would never shut up about it. After about a month of their absence, I looked through some of Andrew's research. He highlighted and took notes from Bruce Hudson's book, My Personal Encounters with the Martin Family, which detailed information on the cult found in Tennessee and Exshire, England. Before he left, he gave me a call. I recorded it just in case because I felt like he was in way over his head.
Hey, it's Andrew.
Hey, Andrew. What's up?
Nothing much. Drew, Kayla, and I are about to go look for that campsite.
Andy, I think you're getting way too obsessed with this.
I know, but it's something I've always wanted to do.
Andy, please drop it.
What's your problem?
I don't have a problem. I'm just worried.
I won't be alone. I'll bring my friends.
Yeah, I'm worried you'll put them in danger. Andy?
These teammates were called to action when the zombies rose from the dead. It didn't end well.
Oh crap, there's a lot of them!
It is the new independent horror comedy sensation that's sweeping the nation.
Sorry, sir. There's zombies out there.
Y'all just go to the kitchen.
Grave Danger, rated R, coming this Halloween.
You saw it. Here at Arnie's, we make quality meat. No artificial preservatives, no GMOs, just pure healthy meat from a healthy cow. Feeling hungry? Come down to Arnie's Burger Joint, located in Stevenson, Mississippi. Want some real healthy beef? Come eat at Arnie's. We got no worms. Blech.
You ever wanted to fly in the sky? Discover other worlds beyond the clouds? Now you can as you play Islands in the Sky. You can fly and explore these islands where you must overcome challenges and monsters. Islands in the Sky. Only available for the Nintendo 64. Available in stores only for $29.95. Rated
K-Tag. Hi, I'm Billy. You may not know this, but I run my own video store, Valiant Videos. We've run this family business for 12 years now, and it's getting even better. We have more movies on video than ever before, including laser discs, video games, and record albums. But that's not all. We're adding the brand new DVDs to our inventory as well. You can rent a lot of your favorite films from here with your very own Valiant Videos membership card. You'll get to see classic movies, horror movies, and even amateur movies. That's right, I said amateur movies. Because if you've got a VHS camcorder or any camcorder, you can make your own amateur movie and we'll put it up for rent here at Valiant Videos. If you're interested, come down to Valiant Videos here in downtown Millardsville. Call the number below if you have any questions.
We're here for another update. The storm is hitting us hard, and we are keeping shelter.
We may have to stay here overnight. As for Chastity Martin, she's spoken once, saying that Reggie Burroughs is supposedly her slave now. One of our doctors fainted and claimed that Reggie's dead body apparently turned his head and smiled at her. She's unconscious now, so she's being treated at the moment. We will now go to Tyrone, who's doing live coverage on the storm.
We're on the site of Highway 55 in Old Millsville. The rain has stopped for now, though we're expecting it to pick back up soon. The tornado did some damage through here, and some people are trapped in the nearby Dollar General until things are expected to get better. In other bizarre events, firefighters are putting out a fire at the old Terriot Family Foundation Church in the backwoods of Stanton Roads. It appears to be man-made, however, as some relics of the Martin family cult were found around the area. Hopefully the storm could be a blessing in disguise and help our poor firefighters. Now back to you, Adrian.
Thanks, Tyrone. So far, the storm appears to be continuing on outside. We're preparing a cell for Chastity, and we're all preparing for staying here overnight. We will continue with our program like usual and update you with any new information. Stay safe, everyone.
It is day two. Hey guys, rise and shine. I want to check out the shed over here. Hey, Leatherface, Jason Voorhees, you guys home? Experiencing a hurricane, and I was at my grandma's, and like, let's say there were like these clothes on the clothesline that kept flapping up and down and up and down like this. Nice and windy out here. There's some more we can explore. Because Walker Winston is insane. On the second day, he shot Carl with an arrow. I could tell that he did it on purpose. On that night, I looked in his secret box while he was out. He had what looked like these dead little demons or something. I also saw that he took matches with him, and Mikey and Paul's hut burned down later. At night, when Walker came back, I eavesdropped on him in his secret room. Hey, that must be the room that was locked. He was begging and pleading to something unholy. I could hear demonic laughing. The room was red and the lights were flickering. I know I wasn't dreaming this. The next night, while Walker was out, I went to escape. I saw Walker, though. He took Marty's body out of the old car to the creek. I went to hide at the burned hut. I found the bodies of Carl, Mikey, and Paul. If anyone reads this, believe me when I say that Walker Winston is an evil crazy. That took a dark turn really quickly. Maybe the legends are true after all. I don't know if he's still alive or what, like.
How long ago was this?
This is in the 50s.
We investigated and analyzed the journals, but couldn't find any conclusive evidence. One of these journals actually also appeared to look a little more modern, which confused us.
Nobody ever knew what happened to Walker Winston. I mean, some say he was a ghost, some say
he was killed. We just don't know.
What was strange is that Walker Winston was never truly found. Some believed he had vanished. No child who was killed or was found or identified.
While there is no hardcore evidence of the paranormal yet, I myself am a firm believer. Another cursed area in Mississippi is Stanton Lake, where a group of investigators led by Detective Wilson has died.
Walker Winston was also in a gray area, where we couldn't pinpoint what was real or just an urban legend. While he was talked about among the people in Millardsville, no one ever really knew him or had any photos or film reels of him. To this day, we don't know if he's alive, dead, or even real.
That's another reason I'm worried for him, because it seemed like he was just chasing a myth. It seemed that he also got his friend Drew a little too obsessed with it too, not to mention it served as escapism for Drew.
Trey was also one of my very good students.
While Drew could get along with Andrew, they also wanted to escape Andrew and be taken seriously as they were mistreated for their own identity. They were a fantastic student and a great person, but suffered from personal issues.
Drew Lawrence was a transsexual who was always mistreated for who they wanted to be. They hoped to keep their secrets safe, and it got worse when Kyla shared this information with everyone at the school. At one point, Andrew and his siblings had to keep Drew from committing suicide. In the following footage, we see how Drew had enough with Kyla.
So that was the second day. It was kind of weird. We found a journal. We've heard some more strange noises. We still can't get that damn door to open. But other than that, I mean, I haven't really experienced any ghosts or anything like that. What do you think?
Maybe we could try to, like, pick the lock or something.
I was thinking we could just kick it down.
You could try.
What do you think we should do tomorrow?
Maybe we could try to find more journals.
Maybe explore more in the woods, or maybe go to that car again. There might could be something in there that, I don't know, maybe a key.
Good point. So, how's everyone's lives going?
Just PG.
Okay. So, I thought I heard something again. That was weird.
You should go check it out since you're a man now.
What?
Well, I mean, you're a man now. I mean, why not? Why not just, you know, check it out for us? I feel safer.
Do you think before you say things? Camera.
trans or I'm a guy, you put me in danger. If you want to know how it feels, I can show you. That's fine.
About that room, I think I'm actually going to put my camera there and see if I can record anything tonight. I'm curious about what's in that door. I'm not sure, but I am going to leave this camera right here to see if anything unusual happens.
You've been hearing news on the crime. You've been watching the verdict. Soon it will become a movie for Unusual Entertainment TV. When Chastity Futrell becomes a lesbian, her father, Reggie Burroughs, won't have it. He kicks her out and she joins a cult to plot her revenge. Organized Patricide, the Chastity Martin story. Premiering on January 3rd, 1998.
The man who's a hit around the world is coming to America.
He's a genius, huh?
That's what they tell me.
B. Rated PG-13. Opens Friday, November 7th at theaters everywhere.
Well, they never have the movie I want. So I end up watching The Bone Animal Attack Part 4.
Wait a minute.
They actually have it.
More copies of new releases than ever before. Believers!
What's going on around here, huh?
Go home happy.
All day long requires concentration. Someone hold my calls. I'm on a Big Mac vacation.
Did somebody say McDonald's?
Hey,
one comedy in America is Austin Powers.
Smashing baby!
Siskel and Ebert.
Escaped inmates, Vic Martin, Kruger Martin, and Chandler Martin, were found to be responsible for the burning of the Terriot Family Foundation Church. They were said to have been working under the underworld crime lord Willard Martin Jr., in which they are known for kidnapping innocent victims for their rituals. These three men were caught but managed to escape, killing a police officer and leaving the other in critical condition. They escaped with an unidentified partner in a stolen van from the Terriot Family Foundation TV studio. They appear to be headed for Stevenson. They are armed and extremely dangerous. Stay indoors. If you notice any suspicious activities or anyone similar to the mugshots we'll show you in a little bit, report them to your local police station. We are currently on a manhunt until these criminals are caught and apprehended.
It was really sad for us to see the note Drew left behind was a suicide note. We tried to investigate and look all over the place, but unfortunately, Drew's body was never found.
Wake up. Wake up. Okay, I guess. I gotta tell you two weird things that happened. You remember I put my camera there last night, right? I'll show you the footage to prove it, but no joke, somehow the camera moved on its own. I don't know if Drew did something, or if maybe you did something. I'm not trying to blame you or anything like that. But that was really strange and really unnerving, and I have a feeling that there is something in that room.
Was it recording the whole time?
Yes.
Is there a way, did you look back at the footage to see anything?
Yes, I didn't see anyone else. I didn't see you or Drew. The strangest thing is I went to go check on Drew, and they're not in their room right now. They left a little note saying that they feel bad for how you were, for what you were doing, and they said that they're going to the hut that burned down. I don't know what their intentions are. You might want to go find them. So Drew said that they were at the burned hut. That's what said in the note. So we'll just, hopefully we'll find them. You might want to apologize to them when we find them. Well, to be fair, you did embarrass them at one point. They just really did not want to talk about it, because every time they kept talking to you about it, you kept pulling the whole thing that they hurt your feelings. You have to think of other people's feelings as well, cousin. I mean, I'm trying to help you out. Try not to be too hard on yourself. I'm pretty sure Drew is still perfectly fine. They're probably just trying to screw with us right now, because... Drew! Let me see if I can get a good visual.
Drew?
Drew! She said she's sorry. She'll apologize.
Come on, man. Sorry.
Drew? What was that? Drew, was that you? Wait here a second, I want to check over here. get out of here. I am not kidding. I saw a dead body over there.
Oh my.
It's not Drew, but it is a dead body. I can smell it decaying. It looks like it's one of the kids. Let's get out of here. Quick. Just in case Drew comes back. I'm gonna stay up. I'll keep an eye out on that door. I don't know who the hell or what the hell is in there, but we just gotta do so in order to keep an eye out on Drew.
We should go find him, though. It's unsafe for him to be alone.
But I think we checked everywhere that we could. We checked at the house that he said he was gonna be at. Right now it's nightfall and it's not really safe to go in those woods. Whatever hell that was came from in here. It sounded like an animal though, so maybe it is just an animal. I mean,
it sounded like an angry cat.
Yeah, it did. Yeah, I've heard some stories of some cats trying to open a door. I mean, I've heard of some people who, some crazy cat ladies whose cats try to open the door, so, you know.
I just want to put this thing down. Dang it.
Well,
I know it won't help anything, but still.
Jesus, God, how did we protect us? What do you think we protect us of us?
ones who cursed this place. They probably kidnapped my friends. Probably doing rituals.
The arm found in the room did not match anyone in the records. The corpse they found was still there, but was not that of Walker Winston.
We investigated that corpse and found it was dug out from a grave belonging to someone by the name of Avery. We could not explain the corpse of the kid, however.
We found the corpse recently, and me and my team thought it was Walker Winston, but to my surprise, it was someone different. The corpse from that video is no longer there, but he looks a little too modern to come to this camp.
One aspect we do know for a fact is that a convicted grave robber named Alex Stone was digging graves around the old Millardsville and Stanton Road. However, based on DNA testing, it's believed that he committed suicide before the body of Avery was ever dug up, so there must have been a copycat criminal.
Even more unusual was the dead, winged animal hanging in the room.
I investigated this winged creature, which we figured was a dead bat. When doing DNA testing, our equipment malfunctioned and couldn't give us a definitive answer about it.
With no logical explanation, we resorted to believing that there may have been something supernatural. Thus, we sent Richard Dreyfuss and Elmer Vasquez, along with an anonymous camera operator, to investigate the camp's ruins.
We're currently investigating the mythological aspects of this place. However, most of it just sounds absolutely, you know, untrue, more legend-based. However, we believe that we'll end up finding some findings here. But, to my knowledge, I really don't think we'll find anything.
But I take offense to that. As a demonologist, I'm pretty sure that we'll find something of the sort here.
I've been through these sort of things before. I kind of just think we'll be disappointed here, but you know, the one with Mr. Study thing about this, we'll just take your word for it. So currently, as we can see, doesn't seem to be anything but more cobwebs here. Seems to be no strange markings about. Ugh.
God.
Seems to be relatively clean there. God. Claustrophobic?
No, not really. I'm used to this.
Speak for yourself, I guess.
Oh, dear Lord. Do you feel that?
Aside from the dust and the remaining cobwebs on me, no. But, as I said, it does feel a little claustrophobic, but that's all I can pretty much think of. Everything won't focus. You know,
are you okay?
It's kind of like a little heaviness in the air. I think it's all like the dust. It's getting a little hard to breathe.
No. It seems we're in the presence of something. Some sort.
Okay, you know that that's not true, okay? I mean,
you can deny it all you want.
I know
you
it's...
What's that in the corner right there?
That looks like... A reflection? Like, it could be...
No.
Maybe it's someone's shadow.
No, it can't be.
Wait. I don't think there's a reason to go back there again, you know? I mean...
There's so much of a reason here.
I think it's probably a waste of time. You're the one with the fake beliefs here.
Fake beliefs? Who do you think you're talking to?
Look, we just had to get a demonologist to just look at this, okay? Like, just for the authenticity.
The authenticity? Okay, why are you here? Why am I not here alone?
I have something to run here. This is... You gotta make money somehow.
Gotta make money somehow. God. It's right there, wasn't it?
Yeah.
What? There's no way that someone's shadow could have came right there. If someone was there, there's no way of escape.
Maybe the sun was up a little different.
No, you can't keep denying it. There's someone with us right now.
No, there... There's only you and... You and me and him right now.
Calm down. We have stumbled upon something great.
Okay. So if we have stumbled upon something here, it's not hostile, is it?
It could be.
And you're just okay with this?
I'm going to be the number one demonologist in the world.
Yeah, if we survive.
I'm sure we'll be fine. And even if we don't survive, you know, it's still going to be documented.
Who the hell's going to find it?
How do we find this case? People will find it eventually.
There's a reason we're recording it. I mean, we're going deep into the thick.
This is what I've lived my whole life for, and if I am to die for it, then I'd rather die for this right here. Calm yourself. Honestly, I may need to calm myself. I'm really excited.
You know, there... Maybe that grave robber is here that was heard about as of late. I mean, you know, they're just exploring areas trying to...
You saw it yourself. They couldn't have left.
The windows, maybe they could have...
They were closed.
They could have closed them again, you know?
I think we would have heard some. We're not that deaf.
He's a grave robber. He's kind of sneaky. But right now, the findings present maybe, you know, it doesn't exactly have to be paranormal. It could be, just keep my composure. But look... Right now, our findings have presented so far that there is nothing of this, you know, cult to, like, sort of present this mythological upbringing. It's probably just some, just relaying off of fear, of unfamiliarity with this place, you know? So, We will be right back with some further implications of this after further investigation.
New on video, they were as different as three sisters could be.
I'm the one who graduated from law school.
And I'm a successful wife and mother.
Will you guys stop?
But in good times...
I think it's time.
And bad times.
Can we talk about what happened?
They found strength.
Thank you for always supporting me.
In their family.
You my sister girl.
Soul Food on video. Buy it today.
You know who lives in the third dimension? You know who is in control? You know who has the freedom.
99-cent nuggets, please.
We have nuggets for 99 cents.
We did.
We don't now.
They'll be back in November.
Would you want to wait?
No.
Only Wendy's 99-cent super value menu has delicious choices like all white meat chicken nuggets.
And they're always 99 cents every day.
Every kind of takeout has its own box. Chinese. Pizza. Fun. Nobody has more fun than Blockbuster, so if you want great takeout without the calories, make it a Blockbuster night.
You've been hearing news on the grind. You've been watching The Verdict. Soon it will become a movie for Unusual Entertainment TV. When Chastity Futrell becomes a lesbian, her father, Reggie Burroughs, won't have it. He kicks her out and she joins a cult to plot her revenge.
I'm in control now, fuckers. There's a precious priest for the precious church. A church that treated me like shit. These people were just as bad as our little Martin family. They put innocent people through shit and disguised it all as good-hearted cautionary tales. You know it. You saw it all on TV. Well, here's your fucking truth. We're bringing the storm to wipe out all humanity. Then the dead will rise. I hope you all enjoy our little fucking program tonight. This is your kind of sick entertainment, after all.
Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize for that. Our system was temporarily hacked. We don't know by whom, although we have traced the origins to the old Terriot Family Foundation studio in the back alleys of Glinton Street, Stevenson. The culprits have escaped, but we found that they've murdered a kidnapped priest from the church they burned. A priest by the name of Jonathan Ellis. We also found a few dead bodies that must have been dumped there months ago, including the missing TV actress Hannah Swanson and her son. We are still trying to finish our trial as the storm goes on. We have been flooded in, and our power keeps flickering. We will continue with our program and keep you updated with any new information.
What they found appeared to be paranormal. The place was open to human contamination. We can say that something unnatural was caught on camera, but we just can't right out say that it was supernatural or paranormal.
With Drew and Kyla gone, Andrew was left alone. This is the final footage of him before he was killed.
Sun's coming up. I don't know what the was I saw. Closing the door. It couldn't have been Drew or Kayla. They wouldn't do stuff like that. But as far as I know, after that argument, after that note, I really wanted to talk to her about that. Now she's gone, maybe dead or... I don't know what to do. Sun's coming up, I'm still scared out here. I keep hearing noises. I don't know if Walker Winston is coming. Couldn't be, because I saw Walker Winston's dead body in there. At least I think that was him. Seeing and hearing some weird lately. I wanted to talk to somebody about this before I die. I will get the chance, I don't think. But to be honest, I feel like I've been a narcissist to God. I keep getting angry at him, saying foul things towards him, cursing him for so many things. I keep apologizing, but I don't change. I don't try to better myself. If I didn't know any better, I'd say God has probably left me because he was tired of my narcissism. If he did, I couldn't blame him.
Sorry, Drew. If you guys can hear me, if your souls are around here, if you're in heaven, or wherever. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry I got you into this. Drew, I'm sorry about what Kayla did.
Searching the entire woods all night. I searched. I had to get out of certain places, and I felt watched. I felt like something was going to kill me. At one point, I thought I saw Drew. Maybe they're still alive. Maybe it was a ghost. I don't want to assume the worst, but at this point, I don't have a choice. Okay. I have a strong feeling I'm probably not going to get out of here alive. I have a strong feeling I probably don't want to get out of here alive. I probably just want to let whatever the hell is out there just get me right now. Wherever I go to heaven or hell, I want to reunite with Kayla and Drew. I can't get those images out of my head. I have the fear that I got them killed. I want to apologize to my parents. I want to apologize to my brother. I want to apologize to my sister. I know you looked up to me a lot. I just want to say, if you find this footage, don't make the same mistake that I made. Anyone out there, please pay very good attention to your friends and family. Don't give out personal information. Pay attention to their feelings. Don't just only think about your own feelings. I'm not just saying that about Kayla. As I told Kayla, I used to be guilty of that. I talked to people about things about Kayla that were personal. And then I realized that was not the right thing. Too many people did that to me. Even Kayla did that to me. If you guys find my footage, I don't want to feel alone. I still don't know exactly what will happen to me when I die. If I go to heaven, if I go to hell, if I just in an empty void. Let this be a last will and testament for me. James, I want my organs to be donated to good cause for organ donations. I'm not going to need those. I want you to take out my brain first, so that way I won't be able to feel any pain if I still feel any pain. I want my brain to be taken to a lab where it can be studied, so that way I won't be alone, that my conscious memories can still be there for whatever use. I want my organs to be donated. And once my body's just an empty shell that looks like this, you know, I want you to take my eyes last because I love my eyes and I don't want to feel any pain if I'm still feeling anything when I die. I want my body to be buried in the cemetery where my grandfather's buried, the Stevenson Cemetery. And I don't know what Drew or Kayla wants, but even if I'm just a brain in a jar at that point, please take me to visit their graves. This might be a last will and testament. I don't know what else is going to happen to me now. They've vanished. I'm trying to rethink all my decisions. Let this just be a goodbye if you find this footage.
We scanned through all the footage, and unfortunately, it's still inconclusive.
We tried to preserve what we could of Andrew based on his final wishes. Since this was his last video, there was no evidence on how he died or who killed him. Some of us do believe that Walker Winston could possibly be alive and living in the woods as a hermit. If that isn't the case, then there is definitely somebody living around that area. Only Andrew's remains were found until we started to publish the information on our website. It was then that we received a phone call from a man in Georgia named Hal Winston. He claimed that he found human bones that may have lineage to this case.
So, when I was digging out in my garden the other day, I saw something odd. I found out that there were bones in the yard. And human ones at that. Not just some animal that wandered off and got there. Human bones. And I was looking at it, and one of them had a ring on their finger, just like one of the missing persons well, I don't remember her name, but it got me to thinking that somebody had taken this girl and buried her here. I don't know who it was. I just panicked and called the authorities. The people before me, like my neighbors and everything, they told me that the person who lived here before was messed in the head. Something really wrong with him. And now I'm starting to think that it was right.
These bones were all that were left of Kayla. No skull, no spine, nothing that indicated any cause of death. This would mean that whoever murdered her brought her corpse all the way to Georgia, buried it, and moved only a good majority of her remains. I understand that everyone would want a definitive answer as to what happened. In fact, we all do, but there just isn't an answer right now.
While not a full skeleton, they were able to confirm that these bones did indeed belong to Kayla Davis. This still begged the question of where the rest of her bones went. This also still begs the question of who murdered Andrew. Was it natural or supernatural? And where did Drew end up at? Until then, even with the provided evidence and the footage of these unfortunate souls' final lives, this case will still remain open and unsolved.
Just in, ladies and gentlemen, Chastity has managed to escape, killing two security guards. Even more bizarre, the body of Reggie Burrows is gone, and some bloody footprints were found in the hall, as if he just walked off. A note was left by someone claiming to be Walker Winston. Here's the note. As of now, we appear to be hacked again. The storm is getting more violent, and I'm not sure how we'll get out alive.
Ladies and gentlemen, the courthouse has sustained tremendous damage from the storm, and we are not too sure if the weather is getting any better soon. Many are in critical condition and two are dead. The van that the culprit stole was found crashing on fire in the gravel pit of Hickory Grove, but no bodies were found. This means they still may be at large. Before we conclude tonight's broadcast, we want to show you one final message that was left in Reggie Burroughs' blood.